Hey, today I'm going to show you how to use your Raspberry Pi and a set of speakers as a Spotify Connect device. I'm going to assume that you have your Pi already running on Raspbian or another version of Linux and connected to your local network. So the first thing you need to do is plug in the audio cable of your speakers or HiFi system. Okay, so now we are going to connect to our Pi via SSH. In this case, I'm using PuTTY, but you can use any SSH tool like WinSCP. And we're going to log in into the default user here. And the next thing we need to do is paste this line from the description, and this will automatically install raspotify, a tool which emulates a Spotify Connect device. Alright, so once that is done, we enter sudo alsamixer, and we will need to turn up our volume with the arrow keys just until we reach the red range. We don't want our audio to overmodulate. Then press escape to save. And basically, we're already done now. I will just show you how to edit some settings. And for that, we're going to navigate into etc default and with sudo nano raspotify, we are going to edit the config file. Now we can customize the name that gets broadcasted. In this game, I'm just gonna enter Raspberry Audio. And to up the quality, I'm gonna enter 320 kilobit into here and uncomment the line, of course. And to save that, we're going to press Ctrl X, confirm with Y, and enter. All right, so to restart the raspotify service, we're going to need to enter this command, which is sudo systemctl restart raspotify. And now this should be all done, and we just need to open Spotify. And in the lower right corner, we choose our newly created device, which is Raspberry Audio. And this should work now. Alright, so we did hear the audio, it seems to work fine, but in some cases you might not hear anything, and that's because your Raspberry Pi default audio output is switched to HDMI. So if you have HDMI connected, you need to enter amixer cset numid equals 3, and to always use the headphone jack you use 1, and if you want to switch automatically you use 0. In my case, I sometimes do have HDMI connected, but I always want to use the headphone jack, so I use 1. And now the output is always on the headphone jack. Alright, so that's it. I hope you liked this video. Thanks for watching and have fun.